is basically an incredible, or in their words, an exceptional discovery. In reference to docosahexaenoic acid, otherwise commonly referred to as DHA, what we have here is a tumor. And what is occurring is that DHA is overloading the tumor cell, resulting in its disintegration, course over a few days. This is an incredible discovery into the mechanism of action of docosahexaenoic acid, or DHA, and also opens the avenue to greater venues of research and eventually potentially treatment. Again, I want to refer to this as a pilot study because we're not really utilizing in humans. There were some animals involved in the study, but however, though, until it's actually carried out to individuals, let's label it pilot. However, though, it's incredible research. And the wording is so strong and its impact on tumor cells so profound, it is strongly worthy of note. So with that in mind, let us proceed as follows. An omega-3 that's poison for tumor cells, I am not ad-libbing, that is actually the title of the research article itself. So-called good fatty acids are essential for human health and much sought after by those who try to eat healthily. Among the omega-3 fatty acids, DHA, or docosahexaenoic acid, is crucial to brain function, vision, and regulation of inflammatory phenomena. In addition to these virtues, DHA is also associated with a reduction in the incidence of cancer. How it works is the subject of a major discovery by a multidisciplinary team, and I hope I pronounce this appropriately, of the University of Louvain. Researchers who have just elucidated the biochemical mechanism that allows DHA and other related fatty acids to slow the development of tumors. This is a major advance that has recently published in the prestigious Journal of Cell Metabolism. And also, too, it gives you a profound impact of the importance of DHA in our daily diet, especially in reference to in regard to health maintenance. To proceed as follows, the team quickly identified that these acidotic tumor cells responded in diametrically opposite ways depending on the fatty acids they were absorbing. Within a few weeks, the results were both impressive and surprising. Quote, we soon found that certain fatty acids stimulate the tumor cells, bad fats in particular, while others killed them. The researchers explained, DHA literally poisons them, quote, end quote. To proceed, a fatal overload. The poison acts on tumor cells via a phenomenon called ferroptosis, a type of cell death linked to the peroxidation of certain fatty acids. The greater amount of unsaturated fatty acids in the cell, the greater the risk of their oxidation. Normally, in the acidic compartment within tumor cells, cells store these fatty acids in lipid droplets, a kind of bundle in which fatty acids are protected from oxidation. But in the presence of large amounts of DHA, the tumor cell is overwhelmed. It cannot store the DHA, which oxidizes and leads to cell death. By using a lipid metabolism inhibitor that prevents the formation of lipid droplets, researchers were able to observe this phenomenon is further amplified, which confirms the identified mechanisms and opens the door to combined treatment possibilities. For the study, researchers, the animal model they utilized, for their studies, researchers used a 3D tumor cell culture system called spheroids in the presence of DHA. Spheroids first grow, then implode. The team also administered, respond back and move a little back because I kind of chopped that up a little bit. In the presence of DHA, spheroids first grow, then implode. The team also administered a DHA-enriched diet to mice with tumors. The results, tumor development was significantly slowed compared to that of mice on a conventional diet. The study showed the value of DHA in fighting cancer. For an adult, I'm quoting the recommendations. I'm not making any recommendation on my own. I'm just utilizing exactly what they said per published study. For an adult, researchers stated, quote, it is recommended to consume at least 250 milligrams of DHA per day, but studies show that a diet provides an average of only 50 to 100 milligrams per day. When you recognize how vital it is for, as I mentioned, brain, vision, and inflammatory phenomena, it's really something you really want to take into account when trying to review your dietary intake of certain nutrients. Proceed. This is well below the minimum intake. To reiterate, to consume at least 250 milligrams of docosahexaenoic acid, otherwise you find on most shelves, you'll see it referred to as DHA. Often EPA, DHA, but in this case, we're looking at the outcome in response to DHA. But in any case, I'm going to have a link to the abstract, which may explain a little bit more in detail. I could not get a hold of the full study being published as of yet, but still, you got to give gratitude to, you have to give gratitude to these researchers. It is an incredible, incredible discovery. And even if DHA didn't do the job fully on its own, it may basically slow the tumor development in such a way that other treatments can take hold and therefore help heal that person or individual. Again, incredible, incredible research, exceptional, and also in their words, elucidated the mechanisms of the docosahexaenoic acid and its ability to disintegrate certain tumors and why through basically ferroptosis, because it overloads the cells and then boom, basically disintegrates, problem solved. Again, Ralph Tertiano signing off. Gratitude, as always, thank you. First to the researchers, thank you for you. And humbly, I always appreciate your listening or watching, I should say. Again, till next time, see you there.